Hey everyone, welcome back. We are in the Uden Chapel real quick. Just wanted to have an update for the reveal of the end of the last episode, where what happened with 41 Insight. I went back to the Hunter's Dream and actually bought some stuff with Insight because it's really not good to have high Insight. Some people love it, but it actually will make new enemies appear in certain areas, and it will also make certain enemies harder. So I spent a bunch of insight. As you can see, we're back to 14, and I also spent a bunch of our blood echoes on the Tomb Prospector gear and some Molotov cocktails and some other things, but I just wanted to show you, now that we no longer have 40 insight, we can't see our buddy anymore, but he's there. Check it out. Yeah, he's still there. So, that's fun. Anyway, I just wanted to show you guys that so you could see the difference between having a ton of insight and not having the required amount of insight to have that insight, that something is hanging off the fucking Uden Chapel. Anyway, I'm going to cut us to the Nightmare Frontier, and we're gonna get into it. See ya. Hello, hello, welcome back to the Nightmare Frontier. Full disclosure, I changed up one of my runes. We are now rocking, which one? Clear Deep Sea, which increases slow poison resistance. We're gonna need it for this area. It'll be smart to have. I also got, not the entire Tomb Prospector set, but I got the, garb and, the hood, I believe. Yes, I did. So that has some poison resistance on it too, so we might put that bad boy on. It has better physical defense than the church garb outfits. So yeah. And plus, it looks pretty cool. We also have some cairns that we can knock over. Reminds me of Archdragon Peak, or rather, Archdragon Peak reminds me of this place. We also see these weird sort of tombstones that have guts and ooze coming out of them. Can you see that? Kind of a strange little thing with the tombstones here, that they appear to be almost organic in some way. That they have guts. And I'm gonna try and get this bastard. Yeah, give me that bloodstone shard. What the Wandering Madness's drop is a really good indicator of what level you should be when we're here. We're actually a bit higher level than we're supposed to be in here, but that is okay. That hopefully means that it will go a bit easier. We come up here and we're seeing some freaky shit that we haven't really seen before. We can also hear that beast over there where that fire is. We're not gonna mess with him just yet. We're gonna come over to this church garb wearing corpse and pick up Madman's knowledge. No surprise at this point. You can also get a better look at some of these organic bleeding in the bottom left sort of tombstones. Very unusual. And very indicative of the nightmare. That's kind of a nightmare location trait. And we take our first, I believe they're Lauren Silver Beasts is what they're called. Lauren Silver Beasts, I'm pretty sure that's what they're called. And I'm being very, very careful as I tread through here because I haven't been to the Nightmare Frontier in a while. The nightmare portions of this game I don't enjoy visiting. So I don't make it a point to really spend a lot of time there. You can see more beasts, or in silver beasts. And there are also two hunters in this area. Let's see if I can actually, I think I just spotted one over there. Right where my crosshairs are, there's one right there. And I actually can't remember where the other one is. And that guy just snarled, which spooked me a little. But yeah, we need to be careful of hunters who are sort of trapped in a nightmare and will become aggressive to us quite quickly. And I'm actually wondering how I want to do this. Here's a really good look at kind of how there is organic material in some of these tombstones. Viscera, if you will. There's a lot going on with this place, I gotta say. Oh, there's a wandering madness. Okay, fine. I'll let you lead me to damnation. Oh, there's two! I forgot about that, and I have not seen him do that move before. Here. My god. Okay, so you saw one charge up. Let me see if I can get a better look at one of these corpses for you guys. Sort of an open, gaping rib cage. A mouthful of razor teeth. You can see that. They're nasty. They're pretty nasty, and I did not know that they could breathe fire like that, or rather blow on their torch and kind of exude fire. Yeah, I think we're about to have an encounter with one of the hunters here in a moment. Trying to see where he is. I'm actually gonna head back up here for a second. Make sure I don't get ganked on accident. Oh! There's a very large wandering madness. Ooh, which will do some poison damage to you, apparently. But they drop twin bloodstone shards. So, and down there we see some parasitic nasty. Some nastiness, really. Yeah, this place is a, it's a hoot and a half. This is where we push that one Lauren Silver Beast down to. And this is an elevator that we cannot access yet, unfortunately. Woe to us. I cannot promise that we're going to get all the items in this area, because it is a righteous pain, this area is. So, I'm going to come back up here. Oh, I think you're required to jump down, it seems like. Yeah, it might be. You'll also notice this blue lantern over here. I think it'll change color once we pass it, or it may have already changed color. Yeah, it already changed color, and it's just sort of to let you know where you've been. And we should be triggering one of the hunters any second now. Well, where are you then, buddy? Don't leave me hanging. Yep, there he is, right there with the torch. Let's see, he's making his way downtown, walking fast. Could be walking faster. Yeah, come here with your weak ass axe. And he's wearing the Yharnam Hunter set, which we don't have because, frankly, not that good. Ooh, hi. Ooh, he has bolts on his weapon. That was interesting. Oh, the other hunter got pulled. Shit. You just stay behind those tombstones. Okay, we're good. This guy's using the threaded cane and is dressed as a church hunter. And he has a blunderbuss as well, it seems. Alright. Our buddy with the torch and the axe gave us a lead elixir, which we know is born in the worst nightmares, and this guy gave us lead elixir. Perfect. So, both hunters out of the way, we're doing pretty good. And, yeah, that lantern turns blue. And it's held by a little messenger guy, you can see. But yeah, it turns blue to let you know you've been this way before, and the Chalice Dungeons have that mechanic to sort of let you know what rooms you have and have not been in. It's pretty nice of them to do that for you. And I can hear something nasty breathing, likely below us. Trying to decide which way to go. There are so many branching paths in this area. It's really something. We could come this way, but I don't think we want to just yet. Yeah, you can hear something. So this is a fun little trap. There's something shiny, and you're like, ooh, I want to go get the shiny, but you can also... Yeah, you can also hear something nasty breathing. We're gonna go fuck with it. Yep, there he is. Hi! Ooh. Nice. Nice doggy. Nice nightmare doggy. Okay. Okay. And it's just... just two blood vials is all that is. And so, yeah, this guy has flipped the switch and been like, good job, you found the path. Oh, a wandering madness, you fucking... I think this guy's about to lead us to doom. Yep. Throwing boulders, we're gonna go right back into that cavern. I knew that was gonna happen. I'm glad we didn't get hit. That might have been an instant KO. We'll be back. Let's put it that way. Gotta be very careful in this area. If I don't get stuck on a tombstone first. And then there's this massive poisonous lake. And we actually... here, let me get that out of the way. We were spit out on the other side of things, but I can show you what was throwing rocks at us. It was these guys up here where my crosshairs are. So they throw boulders. They're a general pain in the ass. Like everything in the nightmare, really. Ooh, hello. Madman's knowledge picked up from a church corpse once again. Basically anybody who's had some sort of like frenzied contact or really... contact with the Great Ones tends to induce frenzy. It tends to make you go fucking crazy because you're like, what the fuck am I looking at, essentially. Yeah, you find a corpse with a madman's knowledge on it, it means that they've had some sort of contact with a Great One or have gone crazy because of too much knowledge of a Great One. And we have another church garb corpse here, and we get the Fading Lake Rune. I think this is the one I've been looking for. No, it isn't. Fire damage reduction, 5%. And it's the transcription of Great Ones in human voices. Great volumes of water serve as a bulwark, guarding sleep, and an auger of the Eldritch Truth. And how? We will be venturing off into that lake at some point. There is a smarter way than just running into it. And I'm hoping that we can achieve that smarter way. If we came down here, this is where that corpse was that was holding Madman's knowledge. Nasty, nasty, nasty place. Not a fan of the nightmare, gotta say. And can I get up this way? No, I can't. Okay. Womp womp. Looks like I could. And there's also a poison pit that we really don't want to get into down there. And as such, I'm going to try and find a better way to get to the next part, which, frankly, I'm not sure what the next part is. This place is a little bit of an open labyrinth of sorts. You can see the poison pit again. I'm trying to keep an eye on where the dead enemies I've slayed are, because that gives me an idea of kind of where the branching paths are. So I think we're going to... oh no, that's where the elevator is that we can't use yet. Fuck. Yeah, and that goes back to the beginning, where we can't really do much with that. And yeah, it looks like we might have to go traversing in that area where we're getting boulders thrown at us. Shit. Shit. Let me just... oh, there's an item. Okay, this is a fun little trap. You see those shining coins with an item leading to an item? Yeah, that's a trap. That's a trap, buddy. and I might do the trap just so you guys can see it. I don't know if I'm willing to take that sort of punishment, though, to be perfectly honest. It because it's just such a rookie move, man. Anyway, I think I fell for it on accident once. I was like running from something and accidentally ran up there. Okay, that's where, yep, this is, I think, how we're gonna progress forward. Okay, let's be very, very careful with these boulder guys. This will probably go more than one episode, just saying it now. Alright, I see you, I see you. We could use Lead Elixir, and it would make it easier to kind of be smacked in the face with boulders, or we could use Blue Elixir, is that what it's called? Yeah, Blue Elixir, and it would make us seem sort of invisible to the point that this guy would not be able to get a good read on us, and I really don't want to waste Blue Elixir because we can't buy it from the Insight Shop yet, and it is in very short supply, so I think what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna run here, throw, and back here. Yep, there we go. We're getting it. Whoop! And there's that item. Cold blood. Flower bud. Buds, man. Alright, I wouldn't say they're dank buds. Let's see what else we get. Oh, fuck me. Hi! Can you not? One more. Thank you. And I need to get behind something. Fucking Christ. Ooh. Oh, hi! That was not fair at all, you ass. Oh, there's... Perfect. Bolt paper. Very nice. I really don't want to get hit by another rock! Oh, and there's a wandering madness right there. You suck. Fuck! Okay. I'm out of stamina is what that is. Oh fuck. Where did I just jump down to? Okay, we're good. Hey, fine. Okay. Hi. Get dead. Cool. Bloodstone shard. Not worth it, frankly. Bloodstone shard. We are doing better than I thought we would, which I'm probably going to live to eat those words, because usually when I say that, I immediately get fucked in the ass by this game. Okay, there's one up there, so I need to just keep an eye on that direction. And there's also a silver Loran beast, or a Loran silver beast, however, whatever order it goes in. But as long as he's not throwing anything at us and nothing's attacking us, I do want to check on... Cold Blood Flower Bud. It's a chalice dungeon ritual item. Material used in a holy chalice ritual. Pale vegetation that commonly grows on cold blood in a place long ago abandoned. So this nightmare frontier that we're in was long ago abandoned for whatever reason. That guy up there is making me so fucking nervous. And the Loran Silver Beast is over there. Okay. I'll play your fucking game, dude. Actually, I think I'm gonna use a blue elixir. So you see, we go kind of transparent, and I don't think he can see us because of it. It's actually a very good thing for us. Oh! He saw us, though. But that guy still hasn't noticed us. He isn't even tracking us right now, which is really great. Don't want to do that. I'm going to come around here. Ooh. Grab this item. Lead Elixir. Nice. I don't even know if this guy knows we're here right now. Watch me eat my words. He might know we're fucking here. I can't tell if he's tracking us or not. No? Alright. Fuck it. Well, shit. That was way easier than I thought it was gonna be. I may live to regret those words. Alright. Shit. You can actually see what looks to be that cold blood flower bud kind of sprouting up everywhere in here, so place a long ago abandoned. That's basically what we're getting from that. And I think we have to deal with more boulder assholes in here. Can't remember. I think we do. Hence me being so cautious. Oh, that's a large wandering madness. Are you gonna lead me to hell, buddy? Why? Why are you always... Stop it. No, don't disappear. Yes, perfect. Twin Bloodstone shards, didn't really need it. That's okay. Just looking around, making sure nothing's hiding in corners. Okay, that's where we were. We were down there. I can tell by the dead bodies. Is there anything for us over here that we need to be abreast of? Apprised of, rather? No? Okay. This place makes me nervous because I don't know it very well. Okay, there's a bridge, and then here's another bridge. We crossed that bridge, took that guy out. Okay, okay, alright, okay. And this tilts down and makes a bridge back and forth. Very nice. Very nice. Very nice indeed. And did we go through this little crevice over here? Maybe? Did we? No, it just gets us lower because we were up there. Okay. Cool. Really hoping we can unlock a shortcut, potentially, maybe. I know there are two shortcuts in this area. The problem is finding them. Okay, this is where I visceral attacked that guy. Got it, oh, got it, got it, got it. Okay, and then I came up here. Okay, I'm getting my bearings, sorry guys. Jesus. Thank goodness for those bloodstains. Okay, so we can move forward this way. Or the sketchy sort of off the beaten path sort of way, but we have opened up this shortcut or just this bridge that can get us back, so let's do that. Something tells me this will lead to something important, potentially. Just making sure I'm not about to slip into some sort of ambush trap. Looks like there's a silver beast over there and an item over there. And this looks like it just zigzags us down. Wait, you're dead. So I came this way. Got it. Okay, so I came up here, zigzagged up. Okay. Alright, I'm getting it now. Oh, and here is fucking this elevator that we can't activate. Okay, that just looped us around to where we were. Okay, 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 okay. Oh, alright. And it just brings us back up here. So yeah, the way forward is across this bridge. Okay. Sorry, as we figure out... And that's where we were down there, and that's where we fought the hunters. Okay. Alright. It all makes sense now. Okay, and this is where that trap is. You can see the shiny coins being like, ooh, what's this shiny? And up here, you can see the trap. Hey, he has a white face like that guy that gave us the tonsil stone and told us we should be grateful and shit. Huh, it's the same fucking guy. And for those of you wondering, yeah, that's fucking Patches, dude. Patches from all the Souls games. He is Patches the Spider in this iteration. We will learn more about spiders and kind of what they represent. But I want to be careful, and I also don't want to fall for his shithouse trap. We have a church garb... corpse that has given us blood vials. Thank you, sir. And I also hear a wandering madness. Bloodstone shard. Okay, we have more boulder throwing guys. This is the other side of that poison lake. This is kind of... I saw wandering madness appear down there. That's why I was like, This is a tricky little area because we're meant to go along the right, but we also have these boulder throwing pieces of shit all about. So we need to be fairly careful with how we move. We also have that happening. We have Madman's knowledge on a church corpse. Okay. Don't you. Are you gonna. Puke vomit at me? I actually got Molotovs for this very occasion. You asshole. Yay! We only have to deal with two of you now. Isn't that nice? And you, stop barfing on me. I don't like it. I don't like it one bit. I feel like. Ah, there's one boulder throwing guy in a shiny. But first, let's see what they were guarding. They drops thick cold blood, and this corpse is holding frenzied cold blood. Interesting distinction. That means he went crazy. And I say he because the church garb set for females has a skirt and he's wearing trousers, so male. Or at least male identifying. Fuck. Don't know how I want to do this. Yeah, because we go down into the lake then. I think I want to mess with this guy first, the boulder guy over here, just because he seems fairly isolated. Wait, can I even get up to him? I don't know, but I'm gonna grab this first. Stunning deep sea. I don't think I can get up there, y'all. No, I can't. Not from here, anyway. Don't fucking notice me. Don't notice me. Don't notice me. Don't notice me. Okay, good. We picked up stunning deep sea, which I don't know if I've ever actually picked up before. Let's see what it does. Ah, it adds rapid poison resistance plus 200. No, I don't think I've ever picked up Stunning Deep Sea, so this is a first for everyone. Yeah, I've gotten the platinum for this game, and I've also completed the entirety of the Old Hunters, but sometimes, you know, runes aren't required for the platinum, I don't think. Not that I can remember. You want to go down there. But those guys throwing the boulders, I might. Yeah, I'm probably going to use a blue elixir just as insurance. And we have five after I kick this one. So, everything will be okay. We get Madman's knowledge. Oh! Hi! Didn't see you there. Bloodstone shard. And I want to be over there where that guy's guarding. Oh, fuck. Forgot about this. Yeah, now you see me, huh? Oh, fuck. Cool. Eat shit, broski. I don't want to dig through your corpse bad enough because I think I'm on the edge of a shortcut here. At least I really hope I am. Nope, I just went to. Oh, I actually might be on the edge of a shortcut. And that is my least favorite enemy in the entire game right there on the left. Fuck, I am not equipped for this shit. Fuck, 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 fuck. Retreat! Okay, hold on. We need something different for that. We need sedatives for sure. And bolt paper wouldn't be a bad thing either. Okay, those things are called winter lanterns. And if you listen closely, you can hear her singing. We for sure want to have sedatives on the ready. And also out here in the mist, you can see what looks like a ship masts that are shipwrecked, and that is not an accident. Fuck, I hate these enemies, dude. I might, honest to God, just run past her. Yeah, I'm probably gonna run past her. Right fucking shit. Shit. I remember that every time. Fuck! Our frenzy meter's going up. Don't touch me. Take a sedative. Okay. It's still going up, you can see. Take another sedative. Okay. Give Madman's knowledge. That goes down into nothing. She's really close. Don't worry, we'll get a closer look at those assholes, but this is not the time nor the place. We are far too weak for this shit right now. Oh, I see you. Can we see her from up here? From down here, rather? No, but I can hear her singing, and that's spooky enough. Oh, there's another wandering madness. You all are just everywhere today. Bloodstone shard. Okay. Yeah, we're getting to sort of the end of this area. And that's actually good, because that means we're about to open up a shortcut. Madman's knowledge on a church corpse. That is the boss of the area. The shortcut is over there, and that is exactly what I'm gonna fucking open up. I think there is only one shortcut in this area now that I stop and think about it. Blood vial. Hi. Hi. Why are you like this? Come on, then. Stop. Just stop. Ooh, dirty blood gemstone. Yeah, they have a chance to drop some weird gemstones. Oh my god, but praise the elevator. Thank god. Okay. So this spits us out where we were. I will probably explore a little bit in the next episode, but I'm gonna pick it up again right here in the next one. So thank you for joining me. I will see you next time.